I don't think anyone would contradict me when I say that this year has been one of the weirdest for the tech world in general and for the processor segment in particular. Whether we talk about the AI boom and the appearance of the NPUs in all our devices, the fiasco of Intel's 14th generation of CPUs and the launch of the current one, or the ARM offensive, this year we have consistently had processors to talk about, even though most topics have not exactly been pleasant. Even so, amid disappointing launches and rising prices, the light at the end of this year has always been the announcement that AMD would launch the new range of X3D processors. And it's no secret that the 7800 X3D has been, hands down, the best processor for gaming at the moment. At first glance, the new 9800 X3D seems almost identical to the 7800 X3D, which appeared on the scene almost 2 years ago. Both models have 8 cores, 16 threads, and the same amount of cache memory, both L2 and L3. So what exactly are the differences that make the processor launch these days superior to the previous version? Well, one of the biggest differences is related to architecture. While the previous generation was built on the Zen 4 architecture, now the switch has been made to Zen 5, an architecture we encountered a few months ago when we reviewed the new AMD processors with X at the end. This in itself doesn't say much. In that review, we said that the performance increase is minimal compared to Zen 4. So, is it the case here too? Well, here comes the new generation of 3D V-Cache into play. In addition to software optimizations, normal for any maturing technology, there is a fundamental physical change. The 3D V-Cache memory is no longer on top of the chip, as it was on the 5800X3D and 7800X3D, but beneath it. The result? The maximum processor temperature is now identical to that of the non-X3D processors, a sign that the 3D V-Cache memory is properly cooled and no longer needs to limit the processor for reliability reasons. From our tests, temperatures are better and the processor can sustain higher frequencies. Let's get to that right away. While the 7800X3D had a base frequency of 4.2 GHz and could reach up to 5, the base frequency for 9800X3D is 4.7 GHz and can go up to 5.2. If things really stand like this, that is, we have considerably higher frequencies and better temperatures. I say we don't have much to complain about, right? Well, let's see how it actually stands. We put the processor in a PC matching our enthusiasm for the 9800X3D. Gigabyte X870E Aorus Master Motherboard, G-Skill Trident Z5 RGB memory at 6000 megatransfers per second CL28, and the Gigabyte RTX 4090 Aorus Master graphics card. All these were mounted in a Corsair 6500D case with walnut finishes, and cooling was provided by the latest cooler from Corsair, IQ-Link Titan 360RX. The power supply and SSD used were also from Corsair to keep the build thematic. But let's not drag this out and see how we stand in tests. At this point, I think we all know too well that X3D processors are not the best in terms of productivity or benchmarks. But I have a little spoiler for you. This is precisely where we see the biggest leap in performance. Yes, I know how it sounds, which is why I let you see what it's about and just how significant the upgrade is from this perspective. The first test we ran was Cinebench R23, where we scored 23,313 multi-core points and 2,060 single-core points, a significant upgrade from the 18,000 multi-core points and 1,700 single-core points of the Ryzen 7 7800X3D. From the start, a difference of over 25% can be seen between the scores obtained, something I have not seen too often, especially in the current climate, where performance differences between generations tend to be less than 10%. The situation is the same in the 7-Zip benchmark, where we scored 141,000, which is 21% more than the 160,000 points obtained by the 7800X3D. And that's nothing, because in V-Ray 5, the difference was even greater than in Cinebench and 7-Zip. Specifically, the score increased by 31%, from 14,000 points to 18,361. Here's actually the big trick of the new generation. Because the new architecture is no longer so different in the X3D processors compared to the non-X3D ones, the scores are now very close between the 9700X and 9800X3D, so a big plus for the productivity part. You no longer have to choose between a fast gaming processor and one that helps you in work. You can have it all. Moreover, in synthetic tests, which demand the most from the processor, the temperature of the 9800X3D did not exceed 75 degrees Celsius in full load, a value slightly lower than its predecessor. Yes, this processor performs well in synthetic tests and does not reach temperatures that allow you to fry an egg on the processor. But how about gaming? We started with a gaming session in Black Myth Wukong, one of the games vying for the title of the most handsome game of 2024. We set the graphics to high, the resolution to 1080p, and got down to business. Here, the average frames per second comfortably maintained at 139 FPS, that is, exactly the same average frame rate as this game has when using a 7800X3D in this configuration. Say what? This can't be right. Let's try other games. Baldur's Gate 3, for example. I know this game isn't exactly the most demanding graphically, but that doesn't mean it doesn't look downright brilliant and wouldn't benefit from a powerful processor like this one. Here, unlike Black Myth, the graphic API we chose was Vulkan instead of DirectX, otherwise the graphic settings and resolution were the same, 1080p and high. We obtained an average frame rate of 400, a huge number for an RPG of this kind, and initially I was satisfied until I took a look at the frames from the 7800X3D. Surprise! The older processor gets an average of 5 more frames. This tipped the balance in favor of the 7800X3D right from the start, even with an infinitesimal difference of under 2%. I said, however, not to be pessimistic and not to base my entire opinion on the FPS from two games, so I moved on to Watch Dogs Legion. Here, still at 1080p, we achieved 246 FPS, compared to the 208 of the 7800X3D. 18% more, that's more like it. Next up, Counter-Strike 2, because that's what people play. The chosen API was DirectX 11 with graphics set to high and resolution at 1080p. As expected, the frames stayed closer to 1000 than to 100, 750 on average to be more precise. A huge value, and this time higher than that obtained with the 7800X3D, approximately 690. An increase of almost 10%, not bad at all. The next game tested was Cyberpunk 2077. We maintained the same graphics settings formula as in the previous games and obtained an average of 274 frames compared to 258 with the 7800X3D. Just over 6% is not bad at all, considering that this increase comes just from the processor. The last game we ran was an older title, Shadow of the Tomb Raider, which, even though it doesn't have cutting-edge technologies, I find to be quite an important benchmark for this kind of test. You can probably already guess the settings we ran the game at, and the average frame rate was 386. The increase here was 5% compared to the PC with the 7800X3D from 364. The examples could continue, but you probably get the idea. We have a hot one and a cold one. In Red Dead Redemption, we saw exactly 0% progress, in Star Wars Outlaws somewhere at 14%, and overall, in our tests, the 9800X3D was 8% above its predecessor. I have a hunch that the difference will increase over time as the new type of V-cache memory is used by developers to its full potential. But even at this moment, we have a new champion in gaming. In conclusion, we can say without too much error that AMD currently monopolizes the podium of processors dedicated to gaming. But what the 9800X3D brings new is that gaming performance no longer comes at the expense of productivity tasks. We have a decent increase in performance in games, but a very large one in other usage scenarios, under conditions of similar consumption and very okay temperatures. So I would say that we have a winner, if it weren't for the price. The recommended launch price of the 9800X3D is $480, compared to $450 at launch for the processor of the previous generation. AMD already knows very well at this point that the 9800X3D has no competitor in the gaming processor market, so the price might be justified from their point of view. I estimate there will be pressure for the 9800X3D to drop as well. But not too soon, because its lead in gaming against the Blue Camp is quite comfortable. And with that being said, we stop here. I await your opinions below in the comments section. What do you think about the brand new 9800X3D? Subscribe here on our little tech channel. I thank you and wish you good luck.